Okay, welcome back to Mondays with Marta! Today's guest is Parker Glick, and he works for the Statewide Independent Living Council of Georgia. Today, we'll be talking about independent living. So, let's get cracking! Hey Parker, thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome, are you ready? Okay.
So ready.
What does the Independent Living Council do?
The Independent Living Council works very hard to get access in communities across all of Georgia with the disability community. We are folks with disabilities, and we are trying to just enhance the access available in our state of Georgia.
Yes, we are.
And we do that through policy. We do that working with community partners and self-advocates.
Go policy!
Indeed.
Okay, so our next question is, what is it like to do independent living statewide?
Independent living statewide is a little difficult, being that not all of the state of Georgia is covered, or rather can access independent living services. So currently about 23% of our counties in Georgia are not exposed to any sort of independent living services. So we're trying to work on expanding centers for independent living throughout Georgia, and that information is on our website.
That is frustrating, but
yes,
we will get there. We will.
It's frustrating.
Yeah.
Because it's my understanding is that independent living is the best kept secret. At least that's what they tell me.
Yeah, no, I understand.
And this is a secret we want to share with everybody, actually.
Yeah. What made this a reality for you?
Honestly, I want to say birth, but independent living became a reality for me when I decided that I wanted to live my own life. I wanted to move out of my parents' home at the age of 19, and I wanted to go to school for myself. I wanted to find out what my personal dreams were.
That is my dream too.
Through independent living, I was able to, you know, relocate myself and start my own life.
That's good. That's great. Yeah, I want that too. That is my dream also. Okay, so our next question is, what are some of your beliefs about independent living?
My beliefs on independent living, it is a mindset, it is a culture, it's a philosophy. It's very important. It's a catalyst to how we are able to find pride in ourselves, embrace our choices and our desires in life. Mm-hmm. I believe it gives us back our autonomy as people with disabilities, because sometimes, you know, society may change that, may warp that view as to what disability means. And so I believe that independent living helps us changing that narrative.
That's interesting. That's very interesting. Okay, so how do you help others live independently?
I go by the core service of independent living, which is a peer support. And that means that my lived experience could be supportive with somebody else making their life happen however they want that to be. So an example could be, maybe I have a friend that might want to learn how to use MARTA.
Yeah.
And I already know how to use MARTA, right? So mm-hmm. I've got my ins and outs, and they can work through my tips, or they can choose to not do that. That's also independent living, self-determination, being able to make decisions as to who we listen to.
I love self-determination.
It is important.
What have you learned doing this work?
I learned about the variety of disabilities that are make up our world. Yeah. I learned that the medical model isn't always the right way. It doesn't mm-hmm. always have to be the answer. And I mean that in the sense of social model versus medical yeah. model, right?
Yeah.
The medical model is mostly folks with disabilities, we need to change ourselves to be able to live independently. We need to do all these things, we need to be fixed. Whereas the social model says that the environment that we want to choose is what needs to become more accessible for
yeah.
us, versus us needing being the problem, in mm-hmm. quotes.
That is really interesting. Okay, so how can we help as a community?
as a community, I want to say that we can stand together in solidarity. So I want to say that if you have something you want to share with folks, I mean, just being here, I'm telling folks that I'm here. But if you see any of our stuff online, the Statewide Independent Living Council's information online, any of our legislative items, please print that off, share it with folks, and let me know that you did that so that we know who else might be giving us a call to be involved. That, so do whatever y'all can do to try to get folks involved. Volunteering or accessing their Center for Independent Living online.
That would be great if they give you a call because you know a lot about this.
I hope I know enough, yeah.
How do you define disability?
I define disability first and foremost as something that is not negative. Something that should not be, it's not a bad word, right?
No,
disability
it's not.
At all. Indeed. It is also something, sometimes it's a birth given attribute to us, sometimes it's something that happens later in life. But it's a matter of fact, right?
Yeah, it is.
And it is something that we would need to, at any point in our lives, learn how to navigate. Disability is the largest marginalized community that does not discriminate on any account. So it doesn't care about what your race is, your gender, your religious creed, anything. Doesn't care. It can happen to anybody. So it is something I believe that we can be embracing a lot more. And I'm hoping that as we continue to talk about the social model, that helps facilitating that narrative.
I think that's a beautiful definition of disability. Thank you so much, Parker, for coming out on Mondays with Martha, and thank you for giving me your time today. It was a great honor.
It was a privilege to be here, Martha. I appreciate it. And if there are any questions beyond this, please feel free to reach out to me.
Of course. Thank you, Parker.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Monday with Martha! Please remember to like and subscribe. Also, put it on Facebook or social media. And if you want to hear something in the episodes, please feel free to comment and like. And if you want to be in them, feel free to comment and like for viewers like you. Thank you for watching Monday with Martha! Nice.